Hi, welcome back to Hostbox CA channel and back to Computer Architecture and Organization series. Today we are going to see the topic called very important topic and basic also and fundamentals of computer in the area also. Whether you are pursuing BTech second year, third year or different streams, definitely it will be helpful for you. And also moreover, you know, go for appear for any competitive exam and some of the IT companies also. These are fundamental things, remember you. So today we are going to see about the read only memories, and the previous sessions I explained about the internal organization of memory chips, as well as followed by the types of memory, that is RAM and ROM, all as after you know, and also continue with some points about DRAM, that is dynamic RAM and static RAM and so on. So let's go for today's session. Today's session definitely helped to learn the following topics like the exact meaning of what is non-volatile memory, and also ROM, what is ROM and why so much important, and also some of the types of ROM include flash memory, PROM and EPROM and so on, and also real time examples, and also with advantages, what are the advantages and disadvantages of this kind of non-volatile memories in the real time example computer world today. So computer world, so can you imagine the world without computer means? Not possible. So before going some points is there, that means you know already static RAM and SDRAM chips are volatile, and also here it lose the contents when the power is turned off. Now today what we are expecting from the computer means what? Because today many applications need memory devices to retain contents after the power is turned off also. That means what? For example, today if your computer is standard, if your computer is turned on, the operating system must be loaded from the disk into the memory, and also store instructions which would load the OS from the disk, as well as need to store the instructions so that will not be lost after the power is turned off. We need to store the instruction into a non-volatile memory. So let's assume that today I have a computer. In the computer, I'm going to type a Word document a.txt like that. There I'm going to type some information, hello worry like that. So once what happened in the real time, you can save the document. If you not save, it will go, the data will be by default. So if you save the document and tomorrow you come, you switch off the computer, tomorrow you coming, same computer, you want to search the folder, means you can search the document and retrieve the data. That means a.txt, what you typed there at last, hello how are you, like that. That is possible with that of ROM only. And also here, non-volatile memory is read in the same manner as volatile memory. Here non-volatile means what? First, what do you think about non-volatile? That means what? The non-volatile means even power off, we can get the, we can retrieve the data even the system, you can retrieve the data even the power is off, right? And also here the separate writing process needed to place information in this memory. Here the normal operation involves only reading of data. This type of memory is called as read-only memory. So remember, once data read-only memory, these are data will be written when manufacturing only. So once data written, after it not be changed, we can alter the data like that. Here there are different types of non-volatile memories are PEPROM, EPROM, WEPROM and also flash memory. Let's go and discuss one by one. So before, here there will be a read-only memory. Here what is the specialty means, here data written into a ROM when it is manufactured. Okay, so data already written, converse. Now we go to the first category, that is programmable read-only memory. Here, it allows the data to be loaded by the user, and the process of inserting the data is irreversible, and the storing information specific to a user in ROM is expensive, and also providing programming capability to a user may be better. And also it is the first prepared as a blank memory, and it is then programmed to store the information. So remember, here instructions won't be written. Once instruction written, we can't change again. Once instruction written, it won't be changed again. That is the programmable read only memory. So you know computer means what? Instructions, set of programs, or you can say instructions, step by step instructions executed. So fetch, decode and execute the instruction, right? And also what are the uses of PROM today? That means they have several different applications where you can say some of the cell phones, video game consoles, RFID tags, medical devices and other electronics also. Then the question is, what is the difference between PROM and a ROM? Because here that is what means, PROM is manufactured as a blank memory, whereas a ROM is programmed during the manufacturing process. Some of the advantages of PROM, what means, it provides flexibility as well as it is faster, and also it is less expensive because they can be programmed directly by the user. So a user can directly do some programming. That is also only one time, once done means you can alter for particular application. You can use the PROM here. The next one is a PROM, that means erasable programmable read only memory. Here stored data to be erased and new data be loaded, and also flexibility useful during the development phase of a digital systems. And so also once it is erased, it can be reprogrammed. And so also erasure requires exposing the ROM to ultraviolet. So what you understand means here instructions are executed, and also instructions are written. For execute the instruction, we can write the program code again. So once you return means again you can go and do the modification. That is possible in the erasable program read only memory. PROM not possible, but a PROM you can do it. Whatever, we can edit the instructions or edit the program for what application you want, and how do you want to update like that. And also in front of ultraviolet only. Then advantages, it provides flexibility during the development phase of a digital system, as well as it is capable of retaining the stored information for a long time. So whenever you have a stored data, some data, valid data, something, you can get back anytime easily. So long time it have ability to store the data. Then disadvantages, here the chip must be physically removed from the circuit for reprogramming, and the entire content need to be erased by ultraviolet only. The drawback is if you want to do any modification this one, erasable program read over memory, we can with the help of hardware only. That means we can remove the chip and change it. You can insert the new chip, so somewhat costly and not suitable. So let's go for next one, WEPROM, that is electrically erasable programmable read only memory. Here it is programmed and erased electrically only. There's no need of physically removal like that in the practical life. Okay, then it can be erased and reprogrammed about 10,000 times also. And also both erasing program take just 4 to 10 milliseconds, remember. And also in EPROM, any location can be selectively erased, and programmed. That means WEPROMs can be erased one byte at a time rather than erasing the entire chip. Hence the process of reprogramming is flexible but slow also. So remember, for example, what you can say in the real time, for example, I have a document called a.txt, b.txt and c.txt. So with the help of one, I can three documents, a.txt, b.txt and c.txt. So I want to remove particularly a.txt, I can do it with the help of this only. So in the EPROM, where your data stored, you can select the particular location and select completely the a.txt. Next time if you want to, I don't want c.txt, particularly I can do with the help of EPROM as much possible early and quickly. So in the computers, EPROM is a very important one, where it allow the deletion operations very easily, so that take maximum 4 to 10 milliseconds only. Then advantages, it can be both programmed and erased electrically, and it allows the erasing of all cell contents electively. So here also instructions executed, okay, multiple instructions allowed to execute here. Then disadvantage, it requires different voltage for erasing, writing and reading the stored data. That is a drawback of a PROM. Then and also where you can use, it can use it for storing the computer system BIOS. So when you go for any computer in the laboratory or anything, you can check the, as a student of computer science thing, we check the BIOS monitoring. So where it can use the WEPROM here. Then last type of ROM is flash memory. Here it is similar to WEPROM, because here it also read the content of a single cell but write the content of an entire block of cells. And also here flash devices have greater density and also higher capacity and lower storage cost per byte per bit. Then here the power consumption of flash memory is very low and making it attractive for use in equipment that is battery driven. And also here single flash chips are not sufficiently large, so larger memory models are implemented using flash cards and flash drives. So if you want flash memory, then you support it, required support of flash card and flash drive, some of the hardware components. Okay, here, so where you apply means, where you can use means, in flash device it is possible to read contents of a single cell and write entire contents of a block also. Example, where you can use, example, you can suffer for example flash memory and concept is MP3 play, because here the flash memory store the data that represent sound also. So you can apply, you can use in the real time flash memory concept in the MP3 players like that. So these are points remaining regarding the types of ROM. What is ROM and why we say non-volatile, and what is of non-volatile, the meaning exactly, and the types of ROM like PROM, EEPROM, Atlas Flash Memory. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and comment in the post box. See your channel and stay connected with the social media.